dear learners, welcome to Mathematics Lesson Class 7, Lesson 3, Surface Area. So let's look at surface area of cubes and cuboid first. A cube has got all sides equal, and getting the surface area, we consider the number of surfaces or faces in a cube. Each cube, a closed cube, has got six faces. And therefore, getting its surface area, you have to consider all six faces. For example, we have got this one. This one is a closed cube, this one is closed, then this one is open cube. Open, which means the top is open, so we don't consider the upper face. And then this one we consider the six. Here we consider six faces, then here we consider five faces. Now, in this case, we have each side measuring 4 centimeters. So as closed. So closed, you will say it is a 2 into length times length plus 2 into length times length plus 2 into length times length. The six faces, 1, 2, 4, 6. So that is 6. So in this case, it will be 2 into 4 times 4 plus 2 into 4 times 4 plus 2 into 4 times 4. That's a reminder, of course, I learned this in class 6. So 4 times 4 is 16, times 2 is that 2. So is that 2 plus that 2 plus that 2, it will give you 96 centimeter square as the surface area of that cuboid. Then when you go to open cube, we don't consider the upper face. So which means the first one, these two, we don't put 2 because the upper face is not there. So you just say length times length plus 2 into length times length plus 2 into length times length, which means 4 times 4 plus 2 into 4 times 4 plus 2 into 4 times 4 will give you 16 plus that 2 plus that 2, which will give you, it is 64 plus 16, 0 carry 1, 80. It will give you 80 centimeter square. So I have said open cube, you don't consider the upper part. So let us go to cuboid. That one was a cube. Let us now remind ourselves on a cuboid. Closed cuboid. This one is length, that one is length, this one is width, and then that one is height. That one is height. So to get the surface area, closed, is equal to 2 into length times width plus 2 into width times height plus 2 into length times height. That one you know you have learned in class 6. So in this case, it is 2 into 12 times 8 plus 2 into 8 times 5, 8 times 5 plus 2 into 12 times 5, 12 times 5, which means this times this is 40. It is 2 times 40 plus 2 times, no, 2 times 96, sorry. It's 2 times 96, 12 times 8, 2 times 96 plus 2 times 40 plus 2 times 16. This means it is 192 plus 80 plus 120. So 192 plus 120, 213 plus 80, 293. So you will get 392 centimeter square as the surface area of that cuboid. And let us look at the open cuboid. Open cuboid, the upper surface or the upper face is not there, therefore you don't consider. In this case, these two, the lower and upper faces, you consider only one. So the formula will be, the first one you don't include two. It will just be length times width plus two into width times height plus two into length times height. Therefore, surface area equals to 12 times 8 plus 2 into 8 times 5, that is length times width, plus 2 into 12 times 5, which means it is 96 plus 80 plus 120, which means it is 200, which means it will give you 120 plus 18, 00, 200 plus 96, will give you 296 centimeter square at the surface area of that open cuboid. It was only the reminder of what you have learned in class 6, and we are also going to get some questions in this exercise. Now, our major interest goes to surface area of a cylinder. Surface area of a cylinder. Surface area of a cylinder. A cylinder looks like this. That one is a cylinder. This part is known as the top. This one is known as the bottom of that cylinder. And then this one is known as the curved part. Curved part of a cylinder. You can take that kasuku in form of a cylinder, or you can take any figure in this shape that is a cylinder. Now, when you open this cylinder, it will look like that. When you open that cylinder, it will look like that. It has the top, that's the net of a cylinder, and it has the bottom. This one is the top. This one is the curved part, and this one is the bottom. Now, we have got three categories of surface area of a cylinder. Category number one, we have what we call a closed cylinder. Closed cylinder meaning it has got the top and the bottom like this one. The top, bottom and the curved part like this one. So if you want to get the surface area of that one, it has got three faces. One, two, three. Top, curved part and the bottom. You take the upper part, which is the circle, pi r squared. This one is pi r squared, and this one is pi d h, the curved part. So when you combine, the surface area of this one will be, we have 2 pi r squared, the top and the bottom, then you add the curved part. It will give you what? The surface area of that figure. The surface of area of that figure. Now, if we have what we call open cylinder. In the open cylinder, we don't have the upper part. We move like that. That one becomes the open cylinder. Open cylinder, now it has only the bottom, which is pi r squared, the circle of the bottom, plus pi dh, plus pi dh. It doesn't have the upper or the top. That's the open cylinder. Then, number three, we have what we call a pipe, which means the cylinder, it doesn't have the upper and the bottom. It doesn't have. Whatever has remained is known as a pipe. It doesn't have the upper and the bottom. So therefore, the pipe surface area becomes pi dh only, like that. So that's how a cylinder looks like. We are going to look at different examples here. Let us have what we call example one. Example one, you have got that cylinder. You have got that cylinder. Here it is 20 centimeter, and then that is 14 centimeter. The same, you get the surface area. This one is a closed cylinder because it has the top, the bottom, and the curved part. This is our top, this is our bottom, and this is the curved part. So therefore, the surface area, you take the 2 pi r squared plus pi b h. Therefore, pi is constant, it will be 2 times 22 over 7. Radius will be 14 because this is our diameter. Times 7 plus pi dh. Pi is constant over 7. D now is 14 times 14. And then height is 20. Height is 20. This one, 2 times this, 44 times that. So it is 308 centimeter square plus 44 times 20, it will be 818 centimeter. Then when you add 880 plus 11. So you get 1188 centimeter square. That one gives you surface area in case it is a closed. In case it is closed. And then if it's open, it doesn't have the upper. Open cylinder, it doesn't have the upper. So this one you remove, actually the lower part. This one is maybe 28, then this one is 20 centimeter. So if it doesn't have the upper part, then you only take the bottom, pi r squared, plus the curved part, pi d h. That is 22 over 7, radius will be 14, times 14, plus 22 over 7, times diameter 28, times height is 20. 7 year 1, 7 year 2. 44 times 14, it will be 616 plus 88 times 20, 0, 6, 17 plus 17, 16. So when you add, you will get 6, 7, 3, 2. So you will get 23.76 centimeter square in case it is open. And then if it's a pipe, which means the upper and the lower part is not there. Here it's not here, it's not there. Maybe you have given 20 centimeter and here the diameter was 14 centimeter. But remember the upper and the bottom is not there. So which means the pipe, you only take the curved part, which is 22 over 7 times 14 times 20. 1, 2, 44. So it will give you only 880 centimeter square as the curved part. Example number four. If you have been given that a cylinder, and then you have this one. They have said here is 14 centimeter, and then here is 10 centimeter, and then here is 10 centimeter. They have said you get for A is not given. Get for A. That is our last example. Now I have said that when you open this cylinder, it will be in that format, top and bottom. But in case we don't have this one, you have to realize that this one is a rectangle.
representing the curved part of a cylinder. And this rectangle, the width of this rectangle will represent the height of a cylinder. Every time, the width of this rectangle represents the height of the cylinder. Whereas the length of this cylinder will represent the circumference of that circle. Therefore, if you want to get A, then use this 14, this circle, get its circumference, then you get A. And in class 6, you learn that circumference equals to pi b. Therefore, circumference of this circle is 22 over 7 times 14. 14 is here. 7 here 1, 7 here 2. 2 times, 22 times 2 equals to 44. Therefore, our A is 44 centimeters. Always the length of this rectangle represents the circumference of a circle, whereas the width represents the height of a rectangle, and vice versa. So when it comes, don't get confused. For example, if you are given this one, they have said here is 10 centimeter, here is 154 centimeter, and then you have been given that cylinder. Then they say find for radius. First thing, you say 10 as the width represents height. So height of that cylinder is that. But now this length represents the circumference of that circle. So to get this, you use the formula circumference equals to pi d. Therefore, 154 is equal to 22 over 7 times d. So 22d over 7 equals to 154 times 7, to remove that in. 22d is equal to, let's see, 154 times 7. 28 carry 2, 35, 37 carry 3, then 10. So it's equal to 10, 78. Divide by 22. So D is equal to 11 here 2, 11 here 9, because of 99, and then 8 into 88, 8, 2 here 1, 2 here 49. D is equal to 49. Therefore, our radius will be half of that, which is 24.5. Our radius becomes 24.5 centimeters. As simple as that. Thank you very much.